Yeah. I mean, it has been quite an effort for them to come here, especially for Lisa Manjuna, who came from Guangzhou this morning. So thank you very much for being here. This will be a presentation of the, well, that gives you more background in the materials that we have encountered this morning. So I hope you enjoyed this this masterclass of an hour by B.C. Manjunath and Dr. Mysore Manjunath. Please welcome them.
Since I know you guys a little bit, so I thought of stealing the mic from Maestro. Dr. Mysore Manjunath is the jewel from India. So I'm so happy that he comes all the way to Amsterdam and performs here for us and teaches some stuff for us, because this man is so busy. Like, he's one day in India, the next day in Singapore, you know, like, him and along with his brother, Mysore Nagaraj, known as Mysore Brothers, they are like the pride of our country. So I'm very fortunate to be sharing the stage along with Dr. Mysore Manjunath. Please give him a big hand. And as I told to Rafa, you know, like, I don't keep anything inside. So whatever is there in my mind, I just tell it out. Also, in this class, I mentioned that Dr. Mysore Manjunath's name should be in the first place, but it was already printed out. So my apologies to Dr. Manjunath. And yeah, I know what you're going to say, but still, this is something that I have to say from what I have inside. Yeah, what are we going to do today is, I'm not going to say, Dr. Manjunath will say.
You see, he told you the easier things, and then complicated things he wants me to talk. So it's just not verified. Anyway, good morning, all of you, and then it's been such a wonderful feeling for both of us to be here in this presentation. And, you know, it's such a nice thing to be doing this presentation along with B.C. Manjunath. He's such a brilliant and very, very intelligent mridanga player. And then he came this morning from China just to participate in this presentation, and then he's going off tomorrow morning. And anyway, we were just figuring out how to do this one. And as we discussed these things with Rafael some time ago, we are predominantly talking about the Indian concept of mathematics and then improvisation, and then how we do that, and then the place of Ragam Tanam Pallavi, which is one of the highly advanced and very tricky compositional forms in Carnatic classical music, and all those things. And before that, you know, I request B.C. Manjunath to talk to you about the concept of rhythm in Carnatic classical music a little bit, so that with that background, I can talk to you about Ragam Tanam Pallavi and then the two very, very intricate Pallavis, two compositions which we are going to present to you later this evening. And it was little unusual to us because, you know, the Indian classical music is full of improvisation all the time. And then we normally don't plan anything before the concert. Most of the time we sit, we come to the concert, and then we go on the stage and then look at each other's face and then take our instruments and then we just start doing the concert. So that is how it takes place. But today is a little extraordinary scenario because then we had to talk to you about some subtle and intricacies of in Carnatic classical music, mathematics, and then Pallavis kind of things. So, in this presentation, we will not only demonstrate to you those two things, but also, if time permits, we want to show you how the how the mathematics and those things can be adapted even when we are doing the improvisations. Because improvisation is the mantra of Carnatic classical music nowadays. Because as I was telling, we were talking, myself and Rafael yesterday, we don't believe in the concept of rehearsal. There is no need for us to rehearse at all. We simply come and then there is no need for us to even know the co-musicians earlier also. You know, many times we meet the musicians first time in our life on the stage. And then we simply say, hello, oh, I heard a lot about you. Such a wonderful feeling meeting you. How are you doing? And then that's it. And then we on the Shruti box, probably you know what Shruti box means. And then we begin the concert. How does this happen? That is the tricky thing. Of course, we don't have the concept of rehearsal, but we have one very, very crucial and probably the most important thing that we call in Indian language as sadhana, that is a lifelong practice. You know, our practicing methodologies are so intricate, it's so hard that it can train any Carnatic classical musician to do whatever things we do today on the stage. So actually, if you say, oh, you two are brilliant musicians, actually the credit should go to the system, because that is the system which has trained us. So you will, you know, we are probably, we will explain on those lines later on. So let Manjunath begin with whatever he wants to say.
Today we are going to do two Pallavis in the concert this evening, and one of them is in Kanda Nade Aditala, which is which has
Kanda Jati
Aditala, which has like 40 acharas or 80 16th note or 48 notes. So I would like to write something for you guys, what the structure is. And this Pallavi was composed by Dr. Manjunath, and he will tell you what he thought about, how he made this Pallavi. So first thing is, like, I will explain you what is there in the Pallavi, and then can I use the board? Is it okay? Or yeah.
So the count is it's tap 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 to 8 times, and the structure of Pallavi is I will write the frames first. This 5/8 note plus 5/16 plus 5/8 plus 5/16 plus 5/8 plus 5/8 plus 3/8 multiplied by 5. This is the structure which has 48 notes. I guess it is. 25, yeah, 15. So this is the structure of the Pallavi. So where we have, on the first 5/8 notes, we have 4 against 5. And this is just one note. And this, we have here 3 against 5. This is just one note. And here we have 2 against 5. And this is one note. And this one has 4 against 3 plus one note, 4 against 3. Plus one note and so it's 4/5, one note of 5/16, 3/5, one note of 5/16, 2/5, one note of 5/8, and then we have 4/3, and one note of 3/8, 4/3, one note of 3/8, 4/3. You get it? Yeah. So it basically goes like that. The give. Ta ka di na tam, ta ki ta tam, ta ka tam, Takkatinatam. 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 I'll try it again. Takkatinatam. Takkitatam. Takkatam. Takkatinatam. 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 This is the Pallavi. I didn't make it. Dr. Manjunath made it. And he told me this morning. So I don't know what was running through his crazy brain before he did this. Because this is just the frame and structure. And it's like a...
Sorry.
The foundation is this. And on top of this, we build it like what you heard the sound now. You know, like that. So this is the foundation, and we are going to do improvisation on this stuff. So over to Dr. Manjunath.
Thanks, Manju. And you know, the concept of Ragam Tanam Pallavi is built based on the maximum utilization of melodic phrases, melodic brain, as well as mathematical things and that stuff. Probably, I would not be wrong if I say that Carnatic classical music is one system in the world of music which has taken the concept of mathematics to one of the higher and higher and highest levels, highest planes. It has reached that peak that sometimes it is difficult even for professionals to handle that on the stage. So it gets so much complicated, you know. So I will explain all those things. So whatever Manju told you in Takkatinatam, those kinds of things, syllables, I will translate those things melodically and then sing that one. Okay. This I was thinking as I was talking to Rafael yesterday. This Pallavi was born in Lufthansa while coming to. Here now, here, yesterday, and I was thinking of one beautiful scale which is called Simhendra Madhyam. That is one of the very, very popular Indian raga, which is Indian scale, and I was thinking of singing this Pallavi in Simhendra Madhyam, and I will sing this one. And then we will play. Pamagatisa, magatisa, kapisa. Pamagatisa, magatisa, kapisa. Kanisanisa, nidapamapa, sadikamapamagatisa, magatisa, kapisa. Kanisanisa, nidapamapa, sadikamapamagatisa, magatisa, kapisa. Sarisa nisa, padapa mapaga, sariga papa magati saga, magari sa karisa. Papa da paga, mama baba, padapa magari ga baba, magati sa kakari risa. You know? Now, if we kind of make the taram thing a little more easier than takka takkita takka takkita takka takkita takka. This is khanda jati, and so aditalam khanda jati, and technically we call it chaturushra jati triputa talam in khanda jati or khanda jati, whatever. So pa pa ma ga ri sa ma ga ri sa ga ri sa. Sari sa ni sa ga ni ra pa ma pa ra sa ri ga ma pa ma ga ri sa ma ga ri sa ga di sa sa ri sa ni sa ga ni da pa ma pa ga sa di ga ma pa ma ga di sa ma ga ri sa ga ri sa ukala dile ma padna nin mundu mundu nodu padu adala adu taala ha I will try to sing in that pitch. Ra ru na 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 ra 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 ra. Little more volume for my vocal, please. So the concept of trikala. They all know that, right? Rafael, the concept.
Not everyone.
Not everyone, right. The thing is, you know, this is the base structure. How, you know, Ragam Tanam Pallavi actually begins with the improvisation of a raga or a scale. You know, all these things, you know, you can witness later in the concert. So that is the raga thing, and then thanam, and then pallavi. So when we do the pallavi thing, we sing the basic structure like this, and then try doing anuloma, viloma, that kind of thing. That is the three tempos. So usually we take this one as the original tempo, and then we go one tempo lower and then one tempo higher. So, you know, I will sing that one. It will be a lot more easier for me to sing that with the talam in my hand. So, okay. Pa ma ga di sa. Little more volume, can I get, please? Pa ma ga di sa. Ma ga di sa. Ga ri sa. Sa ri sa ni sa. Ni ra pa ma pa ga. Sa ri ga ma pa ma ga di sa. Sa ri sa ni sa ga ni da pa ma pa ga sa ri ga ma pa ma ga ri sa ma ga ri sa
Sa ri ga ba ba ma ga di sa ma ga di sa ga di sa sa ri
tensa pa da pa 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 sa re pa pa ma ga ni tra ma ga ni tra ga ni tra sa re tensa pa da pa 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 sa re pa pa ma ga ni tra ma ga ni tra ga ni tra sa re tensa pa da pa 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 sa re pa pa ma ga ni tra ma ga ni tra ga ni tra sa re tensa pa da pa 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 sa re pa pa ma ga ni tra ga ma ga ni tra ga ga ni tra. You know, this is the technical part of it. You will be really surprised to know that the improvisation based on this, which is called as Nerubal, which is a very, very traditional improvisational form back in Carnatic classical music, that takes place based on this. So, how does this happen? You know, we keep on giving it different phrases, but maintaining the same structure. Pa ma ga ri sa, ma ga ri sa, ga ri sa. This can take different melody. For example, pa ma pa da ni, ma pa da ni, pa da ni. A ni ga pa ma pa, da pa, ma ga ma. Or some crazy like sa pa ma da ni ga ma da ni ma ri ni. You know, some, you know, it depends it depends upon the efficiency capacity of the musicians. And at the same time, you know, we don't actually attempt such intricate palavis when we are not sure of the caliber or capacity of murdagam player. And if he gives one false note, then the entire palavi structure is gone. Okay, so a murdanga player can destroy the concert if he is not too happy with the main artist anyway. So that is the thing. So it's a mutual thing, and then we look at each other's face. Many times we make a little bit of mistakes on the stage, and then the interesting thing is, you know, there is always scope for correction, which we correct immediately. Luckily, most of the time it is not noticeable by the audience. Right? So, and we teach our students back in India that even, you know, to make a mistake is not a big mistake. Not knowing how to correct the mistake is a big mistake. You know, so that's another thing. So you can make a little bit of mistake, but you should know how to correct it, and then so that you can come back to the version for, because ultimately it is you know, we are all human beings, and then we do all these things on the stage, many things influence on us. So one wrong tala putting guy on the front row can destroy the concert, you know, putting some wrong pa ma ga ri sa, you know, the whole thing, because we don't have the talam in our hand when we are playing the instrument. So that is another intricate thing. So this is palavi number one, and Okay. We will attempt the same thing.
Ned McGowan, one of the famous flute maestros of Amsterdam. He's actually conducting our concert tonight.
If I turn blue in the face, I'm sitting on the floor.
Now, we are so happy that the famous flutist, so the wonderful musician Ned McGowan here, is here to keep the talam. So welcome, Ned McGowan.